Welcome to another session of Optical Communication Networks, Unit 5, Skeleton Communication. Today we discuss about the first topic is the photonic simulation tools. Right, why you are going for this simulation tool before going to this photonic simulation tool? Suppose you are going for design, electronic design circuits or electronic circuits like amplifiers, junction diodes, whatever it may be. The type of simulation tools which are available is PSPICE, you know, the software PSPICE. And similarly, you know, the eSIM software, which are designed by IIT Bombay. You know, what is the use? That is, before going to implement hardware, first you have to check the circuit whether it is working or not. So, that's why those are simulation tools, right? Similarly, the PSPICE and eSIM software which are used to check whether the circuit is perfect or not, whether it is success or not. If success, the same circuit we have to implement in hardware. If not success, we have to check again, recheck the circuit and check either any parameter we have to change. Then, after completing successfully, we have to implement in hardware. Then, we are going for MATLAB. That is, we have to design how the signal is going from one point to another point. That is, different tools are available. Before going to use implement in communication. Similarly, for to design IC chips, we are using Xilinx, that is here, which we are using optical simulation tools. Similarly, to design optical communication networks, we have to test the designing circuit in a software. That's why we are going for this photonic simulation tools. Here, the simulation of the photonic systems is nothing but to check what are the components which are used. That is, what is the source, what is the destination, what is the source and what is the sink, what is the channel, what is the multiplexer type, what is the demultiplexer type, what are the different types of optical components which are used, whether it is working or not, whether it is working, how many cycles required to check, how much time we have to check. Right? So these tools are generated by based upon code. That is, it is the only for single purpose only. Are commercial also available? That is, you know, the license version of the software. There is number of users. They are given license. Similarly, this is also for English. Also, we are using either single purpose or commercial purpose. Also, we are using. Here, these communication tools not only for checking, here we have to check what is the speed of the light, what is the speed of the light to transmit through optical fibers. Here, first we have to go for computational photonics. Here, what is, we know that the name itself shows computation. What is the communication table? It is the totally different stuff on the branch of physics. Nothing but computational thing, but it is we have to apply numerical methods to check. Numerical methods we have to check whether it is working or not, how that is the speed of the light, and what is the propagation of the light, and what is the properties. That is the coming numerical. Here in this computational photonics played a main role. Optical communication network, that is what is the behavior of light, what is the light matter interactions, and some computational models. Here the computational photonics is under the experimental methods perform all the computational process by using computer. You know, similar for the things we are using civil engineers and mechanical engineers, they are using CAD, that is computer aided design, for designing. Here also in photonic computational tools, we are also using CAD software, that is like BPM. Like BPM, nothing but BPM here, beam propagation method. The second tool for this photonic computer aided design is EMD. Eigenmode expansion method. The third one is FDTD, finite difference time domain. These are the three algorithms which are available to design photonics. To design photonics by the CAD. Next, present real time, here what are the software which are used? That is where we go for the overview of commercial software for photonics. Overview of commercial software for photonics. First one, the software name is called the OptiWave. Here, this OptiWave wave also available, that is www.optiwave.com, which provides comprehensive engineering design tools. OptiWave software, which provides comprehensive engineering design tools which benefit for photonic, biophotonic, and system design engineers with design engineers with a comprehensive design environment. Here, suppose we are going for MATLAB. Here, the MATLAB is not only for signaling processing. Here, it is having number of toolboxes. Communication toolbox, that is next to, like that is numerical method tool, numerical method toolbox is there, and different type of toolbox are available for different applications. Likewise, the OptiWave also have a number of toolboxes. The first one is OptiSystem, which is suit for design of amplifier and optical communication system. OptiSystem is a toolbox. The second one is OptiSpice, which is used for optoelectronic circuit design software. Next, OptiBPM, which is used to design optical waveguides, which perform guiding, coupling, switching, splitting, multiplexing, and demultiplexing of optical signals in photonic devices. Other toolbox is OptiFDTD. This is algorithm. This is the second order type of numerical algorithm, which is used to check what is the exact accuracy based upon the boundary conditions. The next one is OptiFiber, which is used to calculate different types of losses of optical fiber, that is dispersion losses, birefringences, what is the polarization mode dispersion, like with some of the losses are calculated by using this OptiFiber. Next one is OptiGrating, which is used the coupled mode theory to model the light and enable analysis and synthesis of gratings. These are some of the toolboxes are available in the OptiWave software. Next, the second software is RSoft. That is the software available at www.rsoftdesign.com. This RSoft, which is used to analyze complex photonic devices and components through industry-leading computer-aided design. Especially this is software used for industry-leading. It is used to determine the performance of optical telecom and datacom links. And the RSoft, which is used to do cost-effective deployment of DWDM, SONET technologies, while designing, optimizing an optical network. This is about RSoft. Next, third one is Photon Design. www.photond.com, which used to design a passive and active optical components design, that is such as the spin wave and crystal wave. Here, spin wave, remember, it is a full vectorical mode finder for waveguide structures anoid. Okay. Second one is crystal wave. It is used to design environmental condition, layout, and design integrated optic photonics. This is about the third software which is used. Next, fourth one is CST Microwave Studio. That is the software that is available at www.cst.com. It is a specialist tool for 3D type of electromagnetic simulation of high frequency components. It is a specialist tool for the 3D electromagnetic simulation of high frequency components. It enables the fast and good accurate analysis for high frequency devices like antennas, filters, couplers, planar or multi-layer structures. And these are the four simulation tools available in real time in present day to check the how to design network here, what is the process for going to implementation and the hardware. Do you have any query in these photonic simulation tools? Please type your query in the chat box. Thank you very much for attending this first session of the today.